kita stop until example 3.13 and then I suruh you continue on the example. Continue tak?
Buat.
Alright, so dapat tak the answer negative 24.526 and negative 8.0764?
Dapat.
Alright, so make sure you show the value for your statistical table, this one. Okay, which is 2.201. Okay, and then this is the lower and upper limit. And then the question asks you to explain your answer. So don't forget to interpret your interval, which is we are 95% confident that the mean difference of breaking strain between wool fiber and synthetic fiber is between this value and this value. Okay, so make sure you show all the calculation and also don't forget to interpret your interval. Okay, so for example, 3.14. Okay, so this is the output for independent sample test. So macam biasa, this is for your group statistic. So the data for each population, which is standard procedure and facilitation tool. So this is the list for sample size, mean, standard deviation and standard error mean for standard procedure. And for the second row, this is for the facilitation tool. And then this is the independent sample test, the output for these two population, okay, which is we have two types of variance, either equal variance or unequal variance. And then if you want to test the equality of variances, we will look at the p-value on living test for equality of variances. And then this is the degree of freedom for equal and unequal variance. So make sure you know that the formula is different for, okay, for equal and unequal variance. So for case for case variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. For small sample, okay, so for case equal variance and unequal variance, what is the difference? For equal variance, dia ada SP, and then while for unequal variance, dia tak ada SP. Okay, but you need to calculate the degree of freedom. So the value for degree of freedom for both formula ni berbezalah. Okay, so this is the value. Okay, so how to get this value? So for case equal variance, so kita akan tengok based on this one lah. Okay, N1 plus N2 minus 2. While for unequal variance, how to get the value? So kita akan masuk dalam formula this one, okay? And then kita ada, so this one kita akan tengok dekat topic 3. And then mean difference, so this is your difference between these two mean, okay? So this is the value. And then standard error difference, so standard error difference adalah value yang after plus minus. So sorry, after your statistical table. So this is your standard error difference. So kalau the question asks you to show this value, okay, so how to show this value? So you akan substitute into this formula lah. Okay, so you akan dapat the value. And then this is your lower and upper limit. Okay, so for example 3.14 for A, based on the p-value in the living test, that's the equality of variances in this study. So we know that for living test, okay, to test the equality of variances, we have four steps. Okay, so this is the step to know either our case is equal or unequal variance. Okay, so the first step, okay, kita kena buat kita punya hypothesis, which is kita ada H0 and H1. Okay, so our H0 is equal variance. So H0 is always equal. Okay, while for H1 is the opposite of H0, so unequal lah. Okay, so this is the first step. And then the second step is our p-value. Okay, so our p-value, how to find the value? So we look at on your SPSS output. So kita akan tengok dekat sini lah. So this is your p-value for living test. Okay, to test the equality of variances. So the value is 0.003. And then after that, your decision rule. So we know that the decision rule for p-value is reject H0 if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. Yeah, so this is the decision rule. And kat sini dia suruh guna alpha 0.05. So we have alpha 0.05. And then our decision, we will compare our nilai, apa nama tu, p-value dengan alpha. So kita kata since p-value is equal to 0.003. So 0.03 compare with 0.05. So dia more than ke less than alpha?
Less than.
Okay, so less than alpha. So since kita punya decision rule, kita kata kita akan reject hash null if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. So since our p-value memang less than alpha, so kita reject ke kita fail to reject?
Reject.
Okay, so kita reject hash null. So bila kita reject hash null, kita tak nak kita punya hash null, so kita mengatakan dia adalah unequal variance. So this is our conclusion. Okay, so maksudnya in this output, kita akan tengok on unequal variance sahaja. Kita akan tengok nilai yang dekat bawah ni. Okay, for case unequal variance. Okay, so that is to answer for question A. Okay, just nak tentukan which case, either equal or unequal. Okay, since kalau kita baca dekat dalam this statement ni, dia tak ada cakap pun pasal equal ke unequal variance. Okay, so you kena test lah untuk nak tahu which case. Okay, so for B. So for B, the question ask you to state. So if the question ask you to state, so make sure just take the value from the output. Okay, usually the mark the marks is only one mark. Satu markah saja. Okay, so how to know either the first or the second row? That's why kita test in A. Okay, so since bila kita test dekat A, kita memang dah dapat unequal variance. So kita tahu for B, kita akan ambil the value for this one. Okay, lower and upper limit. Okay, so just state the value. So for B, just tulis je 22.368 and your upper limit 35.632. Okay, but if in A, you conclude, okay, for example kat sini you conclude, you kata equal variance. So sini dah salah, and then dekat sini you akan ambil value yang atas tu. Okay, you akan ambil 22.478, 35.522. So your answer for A and B akan jadi wrong lah, salah. Okay, since dekat A ni you dah salah, so B pun you akan salah lah. Okay, so make sure when you conclude your hypothesis testing, okay, so make sure you tengok betul-betul. If reject hash null, so our conclusion will be unequal variance. But if we fail to reject hash null, so kita akan kata equal variance. Okay, so since A dengan B ni berkait, so if A you salah, so B pun nanti you akan salah. Okay, so make sure you hati-hati. Okay, so itu adalah untuk A and B. And then for C, based on the confidence interval, can we conclude that the mean difference between the average completion times for the two procedure are differ? Okay, so how to answer this question? Macam mana nak jawab? Macam mana nak tahu dia differ ke tak?
Check sama ada average tu ada dalam interval.
Okay, so since dekat in this question dia tak ada mention any value, so kita akan tengok value zero. Okay, so for C, kita tengok value zero sama ada ada dalam confidence interval ataupun tak ada dalam confidence interval. Okay, if the value zero is in the confidence interval, so kita akan kata dia equal. Okay, but if zero is not in the confidence interval, so kita akan kata dia unequal. Ataupun kita kata ada differ. Ataupun kita kata ada increase ataupun ada decrease. Okay, since if we look at this interval, okay, we have 22.368 and 35.632. So kalau kita tengok, zero is not in the confidence interval. So can we conclude that the mean difference are differ? Boleh ke tak?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So for C, the answer will be yes. We can conclude that the mean difference between the average completion time differ, and then the reason, since zero is not in the confidence interval. Okay, so yes, 1 mark, and then zero is not in the confidence interval is another 1 mark. So usually for these questions, the mark is 2 marks. Okay, 2 markah. And the last one, show the degree of freedom for unequal variance is 8.908. So dia suruh show sahaja, just substitute into this formula. Okay, just masukkan je. So value dia kita dah ada dah dekat this one. So this is your S1 and S2. Okay, so just substitute this value. Masukkan sahaja dekat dalam formula. Since the question ask you to show sahaja, so just masukkan je lah. 6 plus 4.0 square over 6 square over 6 square over 6 minus 1. Okay, so nanti bila you kira ni, you akan dapat 8.908. Since the question asks you only to show the value. Okay, so this one lah, this should be your answer. So any question for example 3.14, boleh? Boleh tak?
Boleh,
okay. So now kita dah cover on one population mean. Okay, so for one population mean, we have two type of cases, which is variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. Okay, so if the question given you the value for population variance or standard deviation, so we know that the case is known, so we will use Z distribution. But if the question only give you the value for standard deviation or variance for the sample, okay, so the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is known, unknown. Okay, we do not know the value for the population, the exact value. So kita kena tengok the sample size. Either n is equal to 30 or less than 30. Okay, so if the case is large sample, so kita akan guna Z distribution. But if the case is small sample, we will use T distribution. Okay, so that is the case for one population mean. So untuk one population, kita ada tiga formula lah. You kena tengok which is the correct formula. Okay. And then for two population mean, okay, we have two type of sample, either independent sample or dependent sample. Now we already finished covered on independent sample, which is we have two type of case, either variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. So for case variance or standard deviation for the population is known is apply for if the question give you the value for variance or standard deviation for the population is known, maksudnya kita ada nilai tu dekat dalam question, so kita akan guna this formula Z distribution. Okay, but if the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, okay, so for case large sample, both sample size tu must be more than and equal to 30. Okay, and tu mesti dua-dua sample size tu more than and equal to 30. If the first one 220, the second one 235, cannot. Okay, tak boleh guna yang large ni. Okay, so kita kena guna yang small sample. Okay, which is yang small sample ni sama ada the first one ni more than and equal to 30, and then this one n is less than 30. So if salah satu kecil atau if salah satu besar, still you kena tengok case dia adalah case yang small sample. Okay, ataupun memang dua-dua tu n tu memang less than 30. Okay, so for case small sample, okay, kita ada two types formula untuk nak guna. Either kita kata equal or unequal variance or standard deviation. So you kena tengok pula lah case yang mana satu. Okay, now we will look at on the last formula for two population mean, which is dependent sample. Okay, so for dependent sample ni, when kita tahu what is the difference between independent and dependent sample. So for independent adalah sample yang has no relationship, tak ada kaitan pun antara first and second. But now for dependent, for both population tu dia ada relationship berkait. Okay, so for dependent sample, kita akan cari the difference between the two population, okay, the data. So nanti bila kita kira the difference tu, kita akan dapat dalam satu nilai sahaja. That's why kalau kita tengok the formula ni, dia sama macam case one population mean. Okay, and then how to find the value for mean for the difference and the standard deviation for the different. So this is the formula. Dia sama je case macam kita nak cari the value for mean and standard deviation for the sample. Cuma beza dekat sini the difference lah, dia ada difference antara dua tu. Okay, so now kita akan tengok on the example for two population means and dependent sample. So another name for dependent sample ni, we call it as match or paired sample. Okay, so maksudnya kalau you tengok dekat dalam soalan tu memang dia kata find the 95% confidence interval of the paired sample. So we know that we will use this formula. Okay, so kat sini dia kata involve a procedure whereby pair of observation are matched as close as possible according to certain relevant characteristic. Okay, so usually for dependent ni kalau two population or two observation tu selalunya without we. Okay, before, after. So dia berkait lah. Okay, and then this is the formula. Okay, so yang Syahir kata, this is how to find the mean and standard deviation for the difference. Okay, for case dependent, okay, kalau kita tengok on one population mean, okay, so bila kita tengok on interval, okay, so bila kita buat interval, dia akan jadi lower limit and then mu and then upper limit. Okay, and then for two population mean, so since dia melibatkan two population, dia akan jadi mu 1 minus mu 2 less than b. Okay, so ini adalah for independent. And then for dependent, so kat situ nanti dia akan jadi lain, dia akan jadi mu d. Okay, so mu d ni refer to case independent sample. Okay, so if you want to write your answer in interval, so make sure you use the correct symbol. Okay, so kalau case tu adalah case one population, you must use mu only. Okay, if the case is two population means, case independent, so you buat mu 1 minus mu 2. But if the case is dependent, so you kena buat mu d. Okay, that's why I kata lebih mudah you buat dalam bracket sahaja, lower limit, upper limit. So kalau dalam bracket ni tak kisah one population ke two population ke, dia akan sama sahaja. Okay, so itu adalah untuk dia punya apa nama itu, final interval yang you nak write tu. Okay, so kat sini dia kata where mu d is the population mean difference in the observation and then d bar is the sample mean difference in the observation and then sd is the standard deviation and nd is the number of differences. Okay, so now we look at on the example. Okay, so in this case, this is the example without the SPSS output. So dia bagi dekat you the raw data. Okay, kat sini dia kata the manufacturer of a gasoline additive claim that the use of this additive increases gasoline mileage and then a random sample of 6 car was selected and this car was driven for 1 week without the gasoline additive and then 1 week with the gasoline additive. So maksudnya kita ada 6 car and then 6 car ni dia akan drive 1 week without gasoline additive and then another 1 week with gasoline additive using the same car. Okay, so maksudnya 6 car tu, ada 6 car kat sini, kita using the same car lah. Okay, so yang the first car ni yang without, seminggu yang without using gasoline additive and then another 1 week yang using gasoline additive. So kita nak tengok ada perbezaan tak. Okay, and then the question asks you to construct a 95% confidence interval for the difference in mean mileage per gallon for car without and with the gasoline additive. So kalau you tengok macam saya kata, if the data give you without with or usually before after. Okay, so kita tahulah this is example for dependent sample. Kalau kita tengok untuk case independent, usually dia tak ada kaitan pula standard procedure dengan facilitation tool. Memang dua benda yang berbeza, two population yang berbeza, yang tak ada kaitan pun. Okay, ataupun dia bagi dekat sini contohnya wool fiber dengan synthetic fiber, memang tak ada kaitan. Okay, but for case dependent, dia selalunya dia berkait lah. Okay, without with ataupun before after. Okay, so itu macam mana nak bezakan the question is for independent or dependent sample. Okay. And then dekat sini dia suruh construct the 95% confidence interval. Since in this question, dia bagi you raw data. So we need to find the value for D bar and SD first. Okay, kita perlu cari nilai mean difference dengan standard deviation of the difference. So how to answer the question for dependent? First step is you need to let your D or your difference. Either you nak buat without tolak with or with tolak without. Tak kisah. Okay, but make sure you mention your D. So in this case, I nak buat without minus with. So maksudnya you cari you punya D dulu. Okay, without tolak with. So how to find the difference? You just minus je lah. 24 minus 6 minus 26 minus 3. Okay, so what is the value? 24 minus 6 minus 26 minus 26.3. Dapat berapa nilai dia? Ah, berapa?
Negative 1.7.
Okay, negative 1.7. And then ni, 28.3 minus 31.7.
Negative 3.4.
Okay, negative 3.4. And then this one, 18.9 minus 18.2.
0.7.
And then this one, 23.7 minus 25.3.
Negative 1.6.
Negative 1.6. And then this one, 15.4 minus 18.3.
Negative 2.9.
Negative 2.9. And the last one, 29.5 minus 30.9.
Negative 1.4.
Negative 1.4. So this is the data. If we let our D, our difference is without tolak with. Okay, so what you need to do with this data yang you dah kira ni, okay, so apa yang you kena buat dengan data ni? So data ni you akan masukkan dalam calculator. Okay, untuk dapatkan dia punya nilai D bar dengan SD. Okay, so how to apa nama itu? Substitute this data into calculator. So you masukkan yang macam biasa lah, mode SD, and then you tekan negative 1.7. Okay, so make sure bila you tekan negatif tu, you tekan, ni kan you punya your calculator kan, you tekan negatif yang dekat atas ni tau. Okay, you jangan tekan tolak. Okay, jangan tekan tolak, you tekan negatif ni. So maksudnya you tekan negatif 1.7 and plus, and then negatif 3.4 and plus, 0.7 and plus, negatif 1.6 and plus, until negatif 1.4 and plus. Okay, and then to find the value for D bar, so you just tekan shift, and then 2, you tekan 1. Okay, ambil yang X bar ni. Okay, so this is your value for D bar. And then for standard deviation for the difference, you ambil yang SX, yang nombor 3 tu. Okay. So, you kira dapat berapa? So nanti you ambil the answer in 4 decimal places. You ambil 4 decimal places. Ada dapat value for D bar?
Negative 1.7167.
Okay, negative 1.6167. Okay, and then your SD?
1.4275.
Okay, so this is the value for D-bar and SD. So what you need to do next is just substitute the value into the formula. Okay, so you dah ada the value, and then our alpha will be 0.05. Okay, since the question asks you to construct 95% confidence interval, okay, so just substitute into the formula. Okay, D bar plus minus T alpha over 2 N minus 1 SD over square root of N. Okay, so just substitute the value. So D bar is negative 1.7167. And then T 0.0, so alpha over 2 is 0.025. And then N is 6 minus 1, 5. So standard deviation is 1.4275. And then N is 6. Okay, so you substitute into the formula. So what is the value for T
0.0255?
2.571. Okay, 2.571. Okay, so that is the value for this one. And then buat macam biasa, dapatkan you punya lower and upper limit. Okay, so how to find your lower and upper limit? Just negative 1.7167 minus 2.571 and then times with this value. So you akan dapat your lower limit, and then for your upper limit, negative 1.7167 plus 2.571 and this value. Okay. So what will be your lower limit?
Negative 3.2150.
Okay, and then your upper limit, just tukar je negative tu ke, tolak tu kepada tambah.
Negative
0.1185. Okay, 3, 8, 3 or 8, 4. Okay, boleh either one. Okay, or you can write your answer. Kalau you nak buat dalam interval, so dekat sini jadi mu D lah. Okay, so that is how to answer the question for dependent sample. Okay, so in this case, okay, why you kena let your D, okay, since you can answer this question using let D is equal to with tolak without. Okay, so bila you let your D is with tolak without, so now nanti kat sini D ni dia akan jadi with tolak without. So kat sini you akan dapat 1.7, 3.4, negative 0.7, 1.6, 2.9, 1.4, and then bila you substitute this value into the calculator, so nanti your D bar, you akan dapat the value is positive. And then your SD, dia akan sama je. So bila you substitute into the formula, so nanti kat sini dia akan jadi 1.7167. Okay, and then masukkan je. Nanti bila dekat final answer ni, you akan dapat 0.2183. And then your upper limit akan 3.2150. Okay, but your answer is not wrong. Okay, your answer is correct. Okay, that's why you kena let your D ni siapa. Okay, so make sure you let. You nak buat with tolak without ke without tolak with. Okay, so both answer is correct. Tak ada yang salah. Okay, so make sure you show your D ni. You siapa tolak siapa. Okay, so any question? For example, 3.15 boleh? Boleh tak? Alright, so if the question asks you to interpret this interval, so how to interpret? Just macam biasa je lah, we are 95% confident that the difference in mean mileage per gallon for car without and with the gasoline additive is between negative 3.2150 and negative 0.2183. So what is the unit? Mile per gallon. Macam tu je lah. Okay, so dia sama je, interpretation semua sama sahaja. Okay, so that is for example 3.15. So in this question, dia tak ada bagi dekat USPSS output. So now we look at on example yang ada SPSS output. Okay, so for example 3.16. Okay, so kat sini dia bagi a random sample of 9 local bank show their deposit in billion of dollar 3 years ago and their deposit in billion of dollar today. So 3 tahun lepas dengan yang sekarang, tapi bank yang sama. Okay, assume that the variable is normally distributed. The data is shown in the table. So kita ada dua data 3 years ago and today for 9 banks. And this is the output, okay, for paired difference. Okay, so once you tengok dekat sini, dia adalah paired difference. So we know that this is the case for dependent. Okay, dependent sample. Okay. In this case, dia tak bagi dekat you the output for descriptive. Okay, dia tak bagi dekat you yang descriptive. Maksudnya dia tak bagi value untuk setiap satu ni. Mean untuk 3 years ago, mean untuk today. Okay, dia tak ada bagi kat dalam case ni. So dia just terus bagi kepada you yang dah di-test. Okay, yang dependent sample yang dah di-test. Iaitu nilai dekat sini. So if the output already give you the pair for 3 years ago minus today, so your D is this one. So you kena follow lah. Okay, since the data ni memang dia dah buat 3 years ago minus today. Okay, so the mean dekat sini, okay, adalah your D bar. And standard error mean is your SD over square root of N. Okay, and then this is your 95% confidence interval for the difference. This is your lower limit. And then this is your upper limit. Okay, and then T, this is we will cover in topic 4 nanti. Okay, dekat hypothesis testing. And degree of freedom kat sini just N minus 1. Okay, so this is how to read the SPSS output for dependent sample. Okay, so usually dia ada lagi satu kat sini, standard deviation, you punya SD. Tapi nanti kita akan tengok output yang ada semua. Okay, yang dah bagi semua. Okay. So in example 3.16 for A, the question asks you to show the mean difference is negative 1.0811. Okay, dia suruh you show your D bar. Okay, your mean difference. Okay, so how to show this value? Okay, actually to find the D bar, kita ada two method. Okay, dua cara nak cari. Okay, so first yang macam I tunjuk before this. Okay, so kita kena follow je lah. Since dekat sini dia punya D memang dah 3 years ago minus today. So our D dekat sini memang yang 3 years minus today. So yang ni you kena tolak satu-satu lah. Okay, so 11.42 tolak 16.69 dapat apa?
Negatif 5.27.
5.27 and then this one? Yang untuk bank kedua?
Negatif 1.03.
Okay, and then this one?
Negatif 2.55.
Negatif 2.55. This one?
1.79.
And then this one?
Negatif 0.64.
Okay, then next?
Negative 0.78.
Okay, next.
Negative 0.78.
Okay, and then for yang ke-8.
0.6.
And the last one.
0.13.
Okay, so since the question asks you to show, so maksudnya you kena tunjuk lah. Okay, so D bar is equal to summation of D over N. Okay, so bila you substitute the value into calculator, so nanti bila you tekan, you kena tekan shift 1, you dapatkan value summation of X dulu. Okay, you tekan 2. So nanti you dapat the value untuk this one, summation of D. So you dapatkan value untuk summation of D, the difference. So untuk this value, you tak perlu show pun dekat dalam you punya answer. So yang ni you boleh conteng dekat dalam kertas soalan saja. Okay, you tak perlu nak show dalam you punya apa nama itu, calculation. Just make sure nanti bila nak nilai summation of D ni, make sure the value is correct lah. Okay, nilai yang you memang dah masukkan yang ini. So ini I tunjuk untuk first method. Okay, yang dia dapat?
-1.0811.
Bukan yang ni, summation of D ni. You kena show dia punya value dia.
Summation -9.73.
-9.73. Yeah, then divide by 9, so you akan dapat -1.0811. Okay, so make sure you show the value for summation of D since the question asks you to show the mean difference. Okay? So that is the first method, okay, how to show the mean difference to calculate the value for D bar. Or another method, okay, second method. So untuk second method ni, what you need to do is you find the mean for 3 years ago and then you find the mean for today. So maksudnya you masukkan this value into your calculator and then you tekan mode SD and then you tekan 11.42 M plus until 1.35 and then you tekan shift 2 and then you kira mean untuk 3 years ago sahaja. Okay, so maksudnya you dapatkan mean untuk 3 years ago and then you kira mean untuk today. Okay, so maksudnya tekan calculator, mode SD, masukkan all this value and then tekan shift 2 and then you dapatkan the value untuk mean untuk 3 years ago and then you calculate pula untuk mean for today. Okay. So once you dah dapat value ni, so kalau you kira nanti you dapat for 3 years ago, you dapat value that is 4.2011. And then for today nanti you akan dapat 5.2822. Okay, so to show the mean difference between these two, so how to show, just minuskan je lah. Okay, 4.2011 minus 5.2822. So you akan dapat -1.0811. Okay, so you boleh nak guna either the first method or second method. Okay, tak kisah. Okay, so that is how to show the mean difference is -1.0811. Okay, so itu adalah untuk the first question. And then for the second question, the question asks you to show the standard error mean is 0.6458. Okay, so this question asks you to show this one. Okay, but we know that in this questions, in this output, dia tak ada bagi dekat you nilai standard deviation. Okay, so what you need to do is yang data tadi kalau you tak buang lagi, so you just tekan je lah shift 2, you tekan number 3, dapatkan nilai SD dia. Okay, so kat sini dia just suruh you show the standard error mean, which is S over square root of N. So SD, if you apa nama itu, tekan your calculator nanti dapat berapa? Shift 2, 3. Dapat berapa? So yang ni you kena cari from value ni from calculator. Dapat tak? Kita dah terclearkan data tadi.
Dah tukar untuk yang 3 years ago tu.
Oh ya. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Tak apa. So nanti SD ni bila you tekan nanti you dapat 1.9373 and then over square root of n. So our n is 9. So nanti dia just suruh you show. So 0.6458. So this is the answer for B. Okay. Since the question asks you to show the standard error mean, so you just show je lah this value. Okay. So ini adalah untuk B. And then for C, state the 95% confidence interval that the mean difference in deposit for the both bank. So since the question asks you to state, so just tulis je lah this one. Okay, lower and upper limit. So macam saya kata, markah dia satu saja. Tak perlu you masukkan dalam formula. Okay. So in this question, since dia bagi dekat output you ni 5 decimal places, so you kena follow the output. Okay, 5 decimal places. So the answer will be negative 2.57024 and then your upper limit is 0.40802. Okay, so this is the answer for C. So make sure don't forget yang depan ni dia ada kosong tau. Okay, dia memang buat titik macam tu je, tapi kita tahu depan ni ada kosong. So you just tambah je lah 80 dekat depan ni. Okay, and the last one, okay, based on the confidence interval, can we conclude that the mean difference in deposit for the bank are differ? So macam biasa, if the question ask you based on the confidence interval, kita kena tengok based on nilai zero. Zero ada ke tak ada dalam confidence interval? So kalau kita tengok in this interval, kita ada negative 2.57024 and 0.40802. So kalau kita tengok zero ni ada dalam confidence interval, which yang kita kata dia adalah equal. Okay, the mean difference tu equal. So bolehkah kita conclude dia differ?
Tak.
Tak. So kita kata no. Okay, we cannot conclude that the mean difference in deposit for the bank are different since zero is in the confidence interval. So macam ni je lah untuk nak jawab soalan D. Okay. So any questions? For example 3.16 boleh?
Boleh.
Boleh. So kalau boleh kita tengok on last example untuk topik 3. So this is the example for dependent. Okay, so many engineering students are having problem in data analysis using statistical software. So a professor who teaches statistics offered to their workshop. The following table give the test score of 7 engineering students before and after they attend the workshop. So maksudnya memang guna 7 orang yang sama sebelum dan 7 orang yang sama after. Okay, so the data collected was analyzed and the output is shown below. So nampak je pack sample test, we know that this is the case for dependent. Okay, dependent sample. So sama, so your D is before minus after, and then this is your D bar, this is your ST, standard deviation, and then this is standard error mean, and then this is your lower and upper limit. Okay, so for A, the question asks you to show that the 95% confidence interval for the difference in mean test score before and after attending the workshop is between this value. Okay, so since the question asks you to show in two decimal places, so just follow sajalah. Okay, just substitute saja dekat dalam formula. Okay, D bar plus minus T alpha over 2 N minus 1 SD over square root of N. Okay, so your D bar is negative 4.714 And then the question asks you to construct the 95% confidence interval, so 0.025. And then your N, you boleh terus ambil this one, 6 or 7 minus 1. Okay, boleh lah. Mana-mana. And then we know that this is the value for SD over square of N, your standard error mean. So just substitute the value. So for T distribution, T 0.0256, what is the value?
2.447.
Since the question asks you to show, so just teruslah negative 9.94 and then your upper limit 0.51. Okay, the question asks you to show in two decimal places, so just follow. Okay, follow the questions. Okay. And then for B, can we conclude whether attending the workshop increases the test score? Okay. So, how to answer this question? Macam mana? Kita kena tengok dekat kita punya confidence interval tu sama ada kosong ada ke tak ada dalam confidence interval. So, dalam this case, zero ni ada. So, bila ada, kita kata dia equal. So, bolehkah kita kata attending workshop increase the test score?
No.
No.
No. So kita kata no, we cannot conclude that attending the workshop increases the test score since zero is in the confidence interval. So that is how to answer the questions. Okay. So any question? So kita dah finish our topic 3. Okay. So for confidence interval, we have covered on population mean. Okay, kita ada 1 and 2 population mean. So 1 population mean macam I kata kita ada this 3 formula. And then for 2 population mean kita ada sama ada independent sample or dependent sample. Okay, so for independent sample, kita tengok either the variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. So, bila known, terus guna je Z distribution. And then dekat sini dia akan jadi sigma 1 square and sigma 2 square lah, variance untuk both population. But if the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, kita kena tengok kepada sample size. Is both sample size is large. Okay, so kita akan guna Z. But if either one is large, okay, satu besar, satu kecil, so kita kena tengok case dia sama ada equal or unequal variance, okay. So kalau equal ada SP, unequal tak ada SP. And the last one is for dependent sample, okay. So before we end our class, so I nak tunjuk untuk case dependent yang mana ada output dia, okay. So this is how for dependent sample, okay. So ni adalah output. Okay, so dia akan ada dua lah, paired sample statistic. So maksudnya dekat sini ni adalah mean untuk before, this one mean untuk after. And then ni N untuk before, ni N untuk after. Ni standard deviation untuk before, ni standard deviation untuk after. Okay, and then this one standard error mean untuk before and then ni untuk after. So usually kalau dia dah bagi yang macam ini, so you tak perlu nak kira yang macam this one. Okay, yang macam this one kalau you nak show tu, you nak show tu you tak perlu nak kira lah nilai yang ini dengan yang ini memang dah diberi dalam table. Okay, dia dah bagi macam ni ha. Nilai dia dah ada dah. Okay, mean tu dah ada. Okay, so if the question give you the data macam ni, raw data macam ni, so maksudnya you kena kira lah the value tu. Okay, so ini dah bagi. And then paired sample test macam biasalah ni D-bar, ini SD, ini SD over square of N, this is your lower and upper limit, ini you punya degree of freedom. So this one dengan this one kita akan tengok on topic 4 nanti. Okay, so if the question ask you, for example this one, find the value for mean. So since dekat sini dia dah bagi memang output dah yang ini, and then we know that our D is memory 1 minus memory 2, before minus after. So just tolak je lah 2.15 minus 4.95. So you get the value for D. Okay, since we cannot use calculator, okay, to find the value untuk the difference ni, since kita tak ada data. So kita tak boleh nak cari this value. Okay, so kita nak buat macam mana? Kita just refer to the mean yang dia dah kirakan. Okay, so any questions before we end our class? Boleh?
Madam, yang nota yang madam conteng-conteng kan, okay? Yang tu akan di-upload kan nanti kan? Yang dah...
Mana conteng-conteng mana?
Yang ni.
Nanti yang full ni saya akan upload dekat dalam recorded Google Meet lah. You boleh check. Okay, so if you have no questions, so nanti macam biasa since kita ada lagi 1 hour ni, so nanti saya akan assign students untuk buat tutorial independent. Okay, so nanti untuk tomorrow class kita akan discuss apa nama itu tutorial, and then kita akan jumpa after raya. Okay, so after raya baru kita masuk new topic. Okay, so any questions before we end our class?
No ada tak? Question.
Tak ada. Alright, so kalau tak ada, thank you for today. Don't forget to fill up your attendance and then see you tomorrow. Thank you.
See you. Selamat beraya, yeah. Mi.
Thank you, Mi.
Esok nak jumpa, jangan nak raya lagi.
Esok. Okay.
Alright.
See you tomorrow, Mi.
Okay.